Greetings to the body of the people. This is a man called Chris Dorsey of the Virginia Militia, and you're listening to Renegade Broadcasting, which is the vanguard of the vanguard. And this is the Militia Intelligence Report. We've got a great show for you tonight. And first of all, during the first hour of the show, we will have the original EPA chemtrail whistleblower, Amanda Bays, a.k.a. Madison Star Moon. She's on the line, and we're going to introduce her in just a minute. We're going to cover a lot of subjects from her testimony before a congressional hearing, an EPA congressional hearing on chemtrails, where she actually uses the terminology chemtrail and discusses how it's dangerous and it's deadly. And, you know, it can be seen on C-SPAN. There's videos. It was broadcast live worldwide. They've been exposed, and she did it. And we're very happy to have her on. She's a good friend, and I'm glad to have her on. And just before we bring her on, just want to touch on and give a shout out to all the other hosts on this network and run down a list of what's going on this week. Of course, Monday through Friday, we've got Truth Hurts with Charles Giuliani. Always a great show. Been listening to Truth Hurts for many, many years now. Of course, you're listening to Militia Intelligence Report right now, which is always airing every Monday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And of course, Sinead, I mean, what can I say? Always a fantastic show. Her YouTube channel is something I watch every day, looking forward to new videos. And the show, absolutely spot on analysis as always. John's great on Wednesday. Always got to listen to John. John's key. John's experience shines through for everyone to hear. Thursday, of course, Circus Maximus. Nick has such a great show. And as I say every week, if you're a serious researcher, you've got to listen to Nick Spiro's show, Circus Maximus. And Saturday roundtable, I hosted this past Saturday's roundtable. It's always a great pleasure, always hearing from the smartest people around in the United States and, of course, throughout the world. We get calls from the UK and Australia, of course. Sean on Thursday nights, excuse me, Sean on Thursdays, Nick on Fridays, Circus Maximus airs on Fridays, my bad. Sean on Thursday, Two's Company, Three's Allowed, excellent show. And of course, Sean does all the engineering work for the network, which is much appreciated. Saturday Roundtable, and of course, Sunday, last night's show with Urban Jungle Girl on the Solar Storm is a must listen. If you haven't listened to it before this point, go listen to it. As soon as you're done listening to our program, it's a must listen and it's essential information. So without further ado, I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce my friend and my co-worker as well. We've worked together for many years, Amanda Bays, a.k.a. Madison Star Moon, the premier whistleblower when it comes to chemtrails, death towers, weather warfare, et cetera. Thank you for coming on the show tonight, Amanda, and welcome.
Thank you, Chris. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, you sound great. Sounds perfect.
Awesome.
Yeah, so just to get into a little bit about how is it that you became one of the first, which I think you are the first, individual who's testified before Congress regarding chemtrails?
Actually, I got an invitation from Jim Lee. He told me that, you know, he had received an invitation from the organizers. I don't really know exactly how it was organized, to be honest with you. I just know that Jim Lee came to me and he said, here's your chance. And so, you know, him, me, Max Bliss, Patrick Roddy, and Joe Lee Diane, and a couple of other people that are in the chemtrail community, went forward and testified before the EPA. And I personally faced people that I had spoken to on the phone for years, you know, and it was very difficult. You know, you have the cameras in your face, your nerves are shot, but we went there and we did it. And I mean, I straight up testified before all of them, telling them that, you know, they're guilty of omission. I stated all of the different many, many agencies that I had already reported this to, who continue to this day to neglect their responsibility, to withhold their duty to investigate these formerly filed complaints. I have a paper trail going a mile long to all the different agencies. And right now I'm working on dealing with Congress, because two of my local, no, not local, two of my representatives that are in DC right now, have stated that they actually sent me emails back calling me their friend, saying that they would, you know, be willing to meet with me. But I've been trying, you know, through emails and phone calls to get this meeting so I can bring in my documentation proving that now it's going on 6 years that I have been formally filing complaints through epa.gov/tips, which is the only way that you can formally file a complaint about airplane pollution, to these federal agents who refuse to investigate it. They negate their duty. And this is a crime. Okay, it's not just a crime about the spraying. The people that are covering this up are criminals. And now I'm to the point where I want to expose the criminals that are covering this up.
Absolutely. So let's take this opportunity to do so. We know that Congress, because we know that you've been documenting this, and that others have as well, I should say, and that they're receiving from yourself and many others, you know, the documentation of this chemtrail operation. And we know that this is a NATO operation, from declassified documentations forwarded by the German government. And we know that it's a UN operation, and it's also an operation of many different agencies of the United States military. And because you're in Virginia Beach, you're in a fairly unique position to see and document all of these things. Would you care to name some of these agencies and maybe get into why Virginia Beach is a key location when it comes to chemtrailing and any sort of clandestine military operations?
Okay, well, Bruce Mayeroff would be one, you know, anybody from the DEQ. I started off at a low level, you know, speaking with DEQ, Health Department, police
officers. And that's state, correct? Sorry to interrupt, but that's Virginia Department of Environmental Quality. Correct?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'll be more specific, actually. Yeah, so the DEQ is the Virginia Department of Environmental Quality, and of course, they would pass me to the EPA. Then you get into the FAA, and I mean, there's a long list. Now, I want to point out something to people. Okay, so Jeff Slaughter is one of the FAA agents that has done absolutely nothing. In fact, he is a criminal. I have him recorded several times lying. We faxed him tons of paperwork, and he would tell me that, oh, he only got half of it. And then he would just disregard what we had sent him and say, oh, well, that had nothing to do with what you were saying, when we sent him like 20 to 30 documents stating exactly what we had, our evidence and everything, never looked over it. So it started off with Dwayne Hunter from the FAA, and then you go to Jeff Slaughter from the FAA. So you've got Hunter and Slaughter. You know, honestly, I think these names are made up. This is just my opinion, but I think these federal agents have fake names, just like my name is not really Madison Star Moon, but that's how everyone knows me. I think Dwayne Hunter is not really Dwayne Hunter. Now, I'm getting a little bit frazzled because I have so many different names and so many people I want to
expose. Take your time. You know, yeah. We'll have you back as soon as you have the names, as soon as you recall them. So take your time. How about the Congress? Congressman?
Yeah. Okay. So the congressman that I'm trying to deal with right now, are you talking about Scott Ridgel?
Scott Ridgel, yeah. I mean,
okay.
Yeah,
okay,
Scott Ridgel, he's quite a Zionist tool. Yeah, absolutely.
Right. Okay, well, Scott Ridgel, my situation with him is, you know, I contacted his office years ago, and I actually got the paperwork where you have to, you know, fill out this paperwork to be able to speak to him and do this stuff, right? Well, then that didn't happen. And so then I started calling them and pressing them, and I have all of these recorded calls on my YouTube channel. You can just look up Madison Star Moon, Scott Ridgel, put our names together, or Madison Star Moon calls Congress or Congressman or something like that. But all of these calls are recorded and documented, and they're for the public to listen to, because these people never, ever stand up for the people. You know, these are hired goons. These are minions. These are people that will not allow us to come in and show them our evidence. Okay, so we went to...
Absolutely. That's perfect. That's exactly what I'm talking about, Amanda. And one thing that I think is key that you stated, that when you went before the hearing on Capitol Hill, you were testifying. So basically what you said... You could do all you did. You're an expert. You gave your expert witness, and you stated for everyone to hear what you have found out that there is documentation for. These are part of military operations. This is not some sort of secret. You're exposing the secret, and you have reached the highest levels of exposing it to these. And I don't disagree with you. I think many of these government, military, industrial complex agents have numerous aliases that they operate under. And I think that that's well documented as being the case. And I presume that that's the case with these Slaughter and Hunter that you're talking to.
Yeah.
So of course we know that. And what we're doing here, what the purpose of this show is, this is a prosecution, because these are facts, not that Chris Dorsey or Amanda Bays are making up. This isn't some sort of story we have concocted. This is reality, what's happening. One has to be, they have to have their head up their butt not to know that they are spraying chemical, dangerous agents for many different purposes, in many different manners from the sky, and not just from the sky, but they're also releasing them into the air, which also, you know, through other measures other than just airplane chemtrails.
Absolutely. You know, I think the reason why they allowed me to speak and testify at the EPA hearing is because they didn't think that I would come in there sounding intelligent, well thought out. You know, they thought that I was going to come in there as a quote unquote tinfoil hat wearing lunatic and just start spewing out all this conspiracy theory, quote unquote, garbage. Okay. They didn't realize that I was going to come in as prepared as I was. And I put them on notice, and I am actually going back either at the end of this year or the beginning of next year for the follow-up hearing. And trust me, this next hearing is not going to be good for them, because they have had an entire year to respond. I have not gotten so much as an email response back from them. Okay, I want to speak a little bit more about Dwayne Hunter from the FAA. I mean, we'll keep bouncing back. Okay, so
hey, Amanda, yeah. Real quick. It sounded okay, but we are getting a little bit of static on your line.
You want me to call in?
What's
the number? Tell me real quick.
Yeah, call. Of course, the number is. Let me find it real quick.
I'm sorry.
Oh no! It's completely. No problem.
Okay.
I think I sent it, but. I'll get it back. Oh, yeah. Thanks, Sean. 747-222-8807.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and disconnect from Skype. I apologize,
okay,
guys.
Okay, yeah. We'll take a call right back as soon as you get on the line.
Yep,
and then
I'm calling you right now.
We'll fill in the dots, and it'll be seamless. Go ahead, and we'll reconnect. And there we go, and we're adding you. Amanda, can you hear me?
Yep, here I am. That was fast.
Okay, yeah,
okay.
Works great.
My headset.
Hey, thanks to Sean in the studio.
Thank you.
In Australia. Hey, great. No, so keep going on, please. We know we're always
okay.
Under attack here, but
right. And
work.
So the thing with my Skype is, I think my entire Skype, channel is just hacked. I'm working on a brand new iMac with a brand new microphone, brand new headphones, brand new everything.
Oh,
it's brand
sure.
new equipment.
Sure. Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
But hey, we got you on the line now. Yeah. Obviously. Yeah, everybody
sure.
knows if they end up on Renegade, they're under some sort of government,
right.
Attacks. So, yeah, go on.
Okay.
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Dwayne Hunter. Okay, yes. So Dwayne Hunter wasn't the first person I spoke with, of course, but he was one of the first relationships I ever had with a federal agent. And so I remember one time, you know, I've called Dwayne so many times, and all of this is documented. If you just Google Madison Star Moon, Dwayne Hunter, Madison Star Moon calls the FAA, I used to call him and tear him a new one on a daily basis because, you know, I was holding him responsible and accountable. He can identify these planes. He can do something about it. And so I remember one time calling him, and I was so heartbroken at the sky, I wept to him, and I really hurt him. I'm telling you, I heard the soul in this man fracture because he did have a soul somewhere in there. And shortly after that, he retired. And in his place came Jeff Slaughter. And so what I think happens is when these people get, you know, they get exposed too much, they have to step down. And in their place has to come another goon. So now it's Jeff Slaughter, who is a much bigger asshole. Can I use that word? I'm
sure.
Sorry. Yeah, he's just a total, complete jerk. He's a monster. He all he does is ridicule me. You know, he'd more than likely probably be one of those people that's trolling me online, you know, doing this type of stuff. He's never done anything to help me. And, in fact, he told me that I had to put all of my questions in writing. And our last thing, just Google Jeff Slaughter, and you'll see that where he said, put everything in writing, and I will be glad to answer all your questions. And I sent him, I said, fine, I'll finally do it that way. And I sent him this email, you know, after, this is after we had faxed him over and over again. And I have all of that documented and recorded as well. But anyways, I sent him a thing, and I said, we need to get these planes identified. We need to get this aircraft taking care of these emissions and all this stuff. And you know what he sent me? He said, I'm sorry, the FAA does not handle aircraft emissions. Thank you.
Right.
And that was his response. Yes.
Basically, what these guys are is they are, you know, psychological warfare operators. They're using fake names. They're intending on doing nothing but wasting your time. And obviously, he doesn't want his voice recorded on the telephone. He'd much rather have you waste your time and write everything down and then say, oh, he didn't receive it through the fax, send him an email, put it in writing. Of course, we've seen it. It's a wild goose chase, to put it in,
right,
in the layman's terms. But, you know, the biggest one of the biggest controlling forces down there in Virginia Beach, Virginia, and in Norfolk and the entire Hampton Roads area is naval intelligence. And I think it is a key thing to touch on all of the military operations and how the United States Navy, but the entire Pentagon infrastructure pretty much has a lockdown on everything as far as the region you're in.
Sure. Okay, so I had my fair dealings with the military. I went up the chain of command, just like I'm supposed to, filing my formal reports, speaking to the proper people, filling out everything I'm supposed to fill out, and I finally reached the top, which is Terry Chamberlain, and he's head of the Environmental Department.
What was Terry Chamberlain's so-called rank and position?
He's like the head of the Environmental Department of all of Oceania. So he's like the top dog
of the military, Oceania, the base.
Military base, yes.
The Oceania military base, okay.
Yes. Okay, so Terry, and I actually testified against Terry Chamberlain to the EPA, and you can see that all on my C-SPAN video. You will hear me actually call him out by name. In fact, I believe he is the only person I called out by name, and I did that because, you know, when you go to the military, you're expecting the military, well, you know, you're thinking that the military is there to help the people. They're there to protect the people. And the fact that I went through everything in the appropriate manner, you know, it wasn't like I just showed up there and was like, I need to talk to him. You know, I went up the ladder, and it took me a long time.
Oh, yeah.
And I did it publicly. Right. So he ended up doing nothing, just like everyone else, basically said it's contrails. You know, I have no evidence, would never look at my evidence. You know, they all know that I have them. Everybody knows that all of us have put forth more than enough evidence to prove with the testing, the water, the soil, the air, the hair, the blood, everything else, our photos, thousands of videos, whistleblowers coming forward, Morgellons people. I mean, you've just got all these diseases and everything. It's evidence. There's tons of us everywhere. But because these maniacs are in control, they're able to just totally ignore all of us. So anyways, Jerry Chamberlain did nothing, but I testified against him to the EPA. Now, I went to the FBI about the EPA ignoring my formerly filed complaints, and the FBI was one of the most heinous organizations that I ever dealt with. You can also find that call on my YouTube channel. Madison Star Moon calls the FBI, and I straight up, you know, called them numerous times, telling them about the chemtrails and the EPA and omission and these people's failure to act and criminal negligence. And the FBI just says there's nothing they can do with it. They don't deal with it. And they're actually very cruel to me. It's really a
This kind of reminds me, and I'm confident that it will remind our listeners that that I guess when one goes through the, you know, number one paradigm shift is that government is certainly not out to help the people, and it is certainly out to hurt the people. But what you're discussing and what you have testified to is that the agencies who are meant to protect us are actually engaged in this chemical and biological warfare against us, which is known as chemtrailing and all the other things that you just listed before I interjected. So that this is part of a military operation. Of course, they're never going to admit it, because those folks who are allegedly the ones to regulate it and stop it are the ones who are engaged in aggressive biological and chemical warfare against the people. So when they investigate themselves, of course, they're going to investigate themselves and say, well, Amanda, we've investigated ourselves and we found that we have done absolutely nothing wrong.
So, yeah. Okay. So I tried to go about it a different way. I have a somewhat of a mentor. Okay. So this man, he's been in the game a lot longer than me. And so his entire premise is to go to the police and file police reports, because the police cannot refuse a police report. So I started trying to do that. I started sending the...
Is that what this man said?
Yes. Yeah, so
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Okay. That's okay. I understand exactly what you're saying. So I went to the actual third precinct, and I went down there in person, and I tried to file reports, and they would not let me. So I started going to the beat cop on the street, started going to them. So then me and my friend actually faxed them all of our information, stating all of the people's names that I had contacted. We faxed the state police of Virginia, and I contacted Ken Stolle, which is the sheriff, and I called Ken Stolle. He's the sheriff here. He's the top dog for police officers, and I spoke with his secretary, because, of course, he's out of the office and unavailable, and I told her I was calling to report a crime against humanity. I explained it to her that I needed to report a crime against humanity, ecocide, you know, terrorism and all this stuff. And that's all recorded on my YouTube channel. Madison Star Moon calls the sheriff. And so she basically acted like the dumbest lady you've ever heard. She had no idea at all what omission was, what common law was. She just had no idea what the law was at all. And that's fine. She's not the sheriff. But the sheriff never called me back.
Well, let me tell you something.
He never even
Let me tell you something that I know. Every single sheriff in the United States is a criminal. And actually, the sheriffs like to state that they're the top law enforcement in the land. But actually, the only constitutional law enforcement in the United States, in Ireland, in England, in Great Britain, in Australia, in Scotland, is the militia. And that's just the way it's written into the law. And that goes the same for the rest of Western European countries. That's the basis of our law. So, these folks are all criminal. And you and I know this, Amanda, because we found this stuff out firsthand. this isn't just discernment of secondhand information that we have. We know that all these guys are in on it. So we're coming up on a break, and I think on the other side of the break, we're going to take a call from one of our associates, Glenn, if that's all right with you, Amanda. And then,
sure.
And then, and then we'll continue on with the weather warfare aspect of what's going on and how, you know, this has been reported, and it's been reported that this is a military and government operation. And would you say that that's fair to say, with all of your experience, that there's private contractors involved, of course, but
okay,
as a large part.
I have a statement to make.
Oh, yeah,
the military is the eyes of the skies. The military can identify and see every single aircraft that is flying over these here United States of America. Trust me, they know what planes are chemtrailing.
Sure, sure. And I would even go farther, because they're regulating, and of course all true regulating bodies are ultimately responsible for the actions of their subsidiaries. And of course, you stated that the military is running it all. And we're going to add Glenn to this call right now. And he's calling from Richmond. Go ahead, Glenn. Have you been listening to the program thus far?
Yes. Yeah, I'm listening to it right now.
Turn that down, Glenn.
Turn it down.
Roger that.
Yeah.
Got it.
Okay. What do you think so far? Because a lot of the information that we're covering, or we're getting ready to cover especially, is going to be information that's contained in something that you wrote up called I think it was called Info Dump, Weather Warfare Info Dump, or something to that effect. But we posted it on Renegade Broadcasting before. It's up on our last week's show, and we kind of want to hit that pretty hard, considering it's death from above. Go ahead, Glenn.
Well, precisely. I mean, it fits in with the chemtrails and their weather warfare. And right now they got a cat four, cat five hurricane that they're playing with out below Cuba, that they're trying to steer between Cuba and Haiti. And it's kind of fighting them, but they're actually making it move and steering this thing. And it's a weaponized, you know, it's weaponized. And, you know, just like the chemtrails that Maddie covers, and what we all are here for is, you know, they're poisoning this planet and making us live under this stuff. We're like living in a petri dish, looking up through all this chemical crap and all this electronic crap. And, you know, it just goes in with what she was testifying with to the EPA. And, you know, I am so glad that I got to be there and cover it. So.
Yeah, okay, well, we'll pick up on the weather warfare aspect in the next half hour, and then we're gonna open the calls up in the second hour for issues that are happening in regards to the mixed elections and the massacre of the Syrian people. Greetings, everyone. Welcome back to the program. You're listening to the Militia Intelligence Report on Renegade Broadcasting. And on the line is my extra special guest tonight, Amanda Bays, a.k.a. Madison Star Moon. And we got Glenn Sutphin just called in. And Glenn, before the break, you were just talking about weather warfare in regard to the steering of this hurricane. I think it's called Matthew,
correct,
in the tropics. And it is moving at what? Between 2 and 5 miles per hour? Or has it sped up now?
No, it hasn't. They can't speed it up because they're trying to walk it through between Cuba and Haiti and without hitting any land masses. It's kind of funny watching the pattern of this thing. And, you know, people say it's not steered. It was going east to west, was starting to go across Central America. It stopped, backed up, turned around, started doing loop-de-loos, and then is missing all the islands, but it's going to come from their track that they're predicting. It's going to come right through the Bahamas. and then it's going to come up and hit around South Carolina, North Carolina area by Kitty Hawk. So, and it's the track. I mean, it goes out to sea and then comes back, and it goes around islands, and it's like, you know, they're trying to preserve it as a hurricane.
Glenn, one thing I like to stick to is the fact that there are anomalies, and that you know, like 9/11, or just like the, you know, train crash in Hoboken, New Jersey, or the school shooting. There's all these anomalies and coincidences that do not occur without some sort of staging in one form or another, or manipulation in one form or another. And we know from these documents, like that in the weather war info dump that you gathered the information for, or in the testimony and documents that Amanda has forwarded to all these different sources, is that this is old technology that, you know, if we didn't know about them sitting storms and making them sit right over a spot after Hurricane Katrina, then, you know, folks are going to be ignoring a lot of the facts and a lot of the whistleblowers who were coming out, you know, 11 years ago about this very thing that you're talking about how these storms can be created, exacerbated, and steered. You know, all we can do is batten down the hatches. But again, this is war against the people. And Glenn, do you think that these are military operations?
Oh, definitely military operations. I mean, a lot of these storms are always preceded by chemtrails. I mean, Amanda can testify to that. You know, there's weather grids that show square clouds, and the only time that happens is in Minecraft. I mean, sorry, the only place you get square clouds is Minecraft, not the real world. And we got square clouds, planes and drones and stuff littering the sky with this crap, and then they hit it with HAARP and produce weather, and they've been doing it ever since I found out, like, Vietnam, you know, they used it in Vietnam is where they started perfecting the technique. So
right, when they were
it's
flooding,
been going on ever
when they were flooding the Ho Chi Minh Trail.
Right. Project or Operation Popeye, I believe it was.
Yeah, I think you're right about that. I want to hear Amanda's thoughts on that. And we've got another caller calling in. It looks like they're calling from Louisiana. So that would be very, very important considering all the weather warfare that's being, you know, carried out. And also, there seems to be a connection with these staged false flag shootings in combination with these weather warfare events. So we might want to touch on that as well. But Amanda, what do you think about these as these operations as being offensive military warfare operations against the American people?
Okay, well, one thing I can state is here in Virginia Beach, they keep us overcast. And they do this so they can continue spraying above the cloud cover. So they cover us with this artificial coagulated chem cloud mess, and then they can do whatever they want above it, and we can't see it. So today, the clouds broke and revealed the most horrific chemtrails ever. You know, so this is what they're doing. It is definitely weather warfare, but I believe it's something even deeper than the weather. You know, I think they almost want us talking about the weather, so we don't look at the depopulation aspect of it, which is something that I truly wholeheartedly believe. I think a lot of people get lost in the geoengineering aspect of it, because when you hear the word geoengineering, and mind you, I am not bashing geoengineering activists. I am one myself. I'm like half and half. But I would say I'm more like 75% a chemtrail activist. But I do obviously believe in geoengineering because it is happening. It's real. We have all the evidence. We know what they're spraying. But when you get down to the depopulation aspect of it, I mean, look at all the diseases, the respiratory illness. And then you look at the plants and everything. The entire planet is dying. I mean,
right.
I looked around my yard and all the plants, I mean, every single leaf was diseased and looked like it was dying. But then I went three cities away and I recorded and documented the exact same phenomena with the plants.
Sure.
And you ask any of your friends, it's all the same thing. So it's like eco side too. So, I mean, is it weather warfare to, you know, like, you know, flood out certain areas or drought certain areas like what they're doing in California? Or is it a depopulation agenda to kill us all? I mean, I think there's so many different nefarious.
It's both, certainly.
Right.
It's both.
Yeah.
And I'm glad you brought up that point because I saw a news story that flashed across one of my news feeds. I think it was either Twitter or Facebook, one of those government-run PSYOP intelligence sites, which we use. We'll use their apparatus because it's actually our apparatus in any event. The public airwaves are free. All of it's Wi-Fi. It should be free to us all. But anyway, I digress because – more importantly to any of this, bees have been added to the endangered species list. Now, when you're talking about weather warfare and about how they were creating this Zika virus that these military operations and government government chemical warfare outfits, you know, along with Gates Foundation and other NGOs, created the Zika virus, and then they started spraying everywhere the Zika virus. And there was a story about a place in South Carolina where all the bees had died due to the spraying to get rid of the so-called Zika mosquitoes, which weren't even around. And
right.
Now the bees are on the endangered species list, and you mentioned the word ecocide. And this also could fit into genocide because bees are essential to the life of our planet. And we cannot have bees go extinct because then we shall go extinct. So that's something to think about, that with these chemtrails, it's not like we can replace bees. That's one thing that we know. These folks who are engaged in war against us, they're playing God. But one thing we know is that we, who are the opposition to these folks and that are playing God, we know we can't create bees. We know we are not God. So we can't create this. So we need to put a stop to this pretty immediately. And I thank you for bringing that up. I think it's a real important aspect because – Amanda, you brought up the fact, hey, it's not just this weather warfare where, you know, it's like the tactics of flooding the Ho Chi Minh Trail. It's also that they're spraying poisons on us, that they're spraying chemical and biological agents, and that this is beyond refute, and that what they're saying is, oh, the poison we're spraying on you is not to poison you. It's to poison other things that just happen to share your environment. So what is that poison going to do? Is it going to only work on the mosquitoes? Go ahead, Amanda.
No, it's about your comment about the South Carolina Zika spraying. So we actually contacted them, me and a friend of mine, who's also a friend of y'all's, Jim Stallings Jr. We contacted the South Carolina Mosquito Control and confronted them about what they were spraying to, you know, kill these mosquitoes and how they had ecocided all the bees. And I asked the man, have you in all your years, now this is the head honcho, okay? I wasn't speaking to an operator. I was talking to the head of operations. And I asked him, have you ever known anyone to become ill or be inflicted with anything from a mosquito in all of your years of working? And he said no. Now, and I said, well, don't you find that odd that you have to spray this toxic material that you know kills the bees, that you know is a neurotoxin and harmful to humans and an endocrine disruptor, and you have to spray this all over our planet, but yet you don't have one case of someone being inflicted with something from a mosquito? It's obvious what they're doing.
Yes.
We are the mosquito.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's right. Hey, great point. I'm going to bring in another caller, 985. Caller, where are you calling from?
Chris, it's me, as usual, David.
Oh, greetings. Greetings, David. David calling from Louisiana. Go ahead. You got something to add about this sitting storms and flooding out population centers? You got a little experience with that, don't you, David?
Chris, I've been living in for 10 years. I don't recognize my own landscape, my home. I grew up as a little boy because of Hurricane Katrina. To make a long story short, I don't live in New Orleans. I live outside New Orleans, about 20 miles north of the city. So I'm mentioning that because I have to bring up that I didn't get flooded like most of the images you saw. But I was in the eye of a storm still in that little 40-60 mile radius. We go outside our home. Everything's fine. Pine trees everywhere. You know, because I live in what you'd call the pine belt. We go outside. 10 minutes later, every one of them are gone. I mean, just like that. It took 10 minutes for our entire landscape to just change. Over what? Over a manufactured storm like we've been talking about. And another thing is the spill in the Gulf.
Would you?
We all know BP was responsible for, but upon just recently, I couldn't believe I found out that was actually intentional.
Now, absolutely.
Anytime you see them make a Hollywood movie about a certain event, it seems like they either want to cover something up or make everybody forget about it or try to.
Okay, and David, just for the listeners, you're referencing the movie called Deepwater Horizon, which is.
Yeah, I was getting to that, but.
Sorry, David. Sorry, go ahead.
That's all right. No. Well, that's pretty much all I had to bring forward to the table. I'm really enjoying what I'm learning from Glenn here, because he's the one with all the info dump information that I've been reading through. But I know he every day he's probably finding out something I didn't know. I'm learning something new every day as well. We all are. That's why we're at Renegade, because we have to educate people on what's really going on, and all of you, Glenn, Chris, and Miss Amanda, are really at the forefront of the kind of action and what people should actually be doing to fight this. They have us fooled into believing, because they control the narrative that it's more complicated than that. We're not meant to understand these issues, and it's up to us to simplify for people and tell them you have the most moral and legal standing, far more superior than to anybody who wears a badge or goes by the alphabetical agency or is an official. I mean, we're it. I'll give it over to you now.
That's right. That's right, David. The Constitution for the United States states we the people ordain the government, and it gives all the reasons why we ordain it, you know, which it's not to be, you know, glossed over or brushed aside. We ordain the government. God creates man and man creates government. I'm going to say it every show, or I hope if I don't, somebody else will, because it's really that simple. David hit the nail on the head, because we must simplify these things. Everyone wants to get confused, whether they go, oh, no, it's not chemtrailing, it's geoengineering. Oh, no, only chemtrail folks are kooks, or geoengineering folks are it's. But Amanda put it very succinctly and as simple and or as complicated as it needs to be. This is weather warfare. This is part of a depopulation agenda. Of course, the issue we cover on this channel is a lot is the European genocide agenda. Now, they want to genocide all the people, of course, but they have to start with their the only one that's challenging them, and that's these European countries or countries founded by Europeans. Those are the targets for these chemtrails because, as we stated, a lot of this is NATO is the operating force behind it. According to declassified documents from the German military and the German government. And of course, Germany is part of NATO, US part of NATO, pretty much Europe, Canada, United States, Turkey, of course, too. But that's where these chemtrails are occurring. And for the most part, those are at least were majority European people's countries, and they're the only challenge, and they're where you know, the Zionist usurpers have infiltrated, and that's where they are declaring their wars, and that's what we see now. Amanda, I want to get back to you because I wanted to follow up on some stuff about how pervasive the indoctrination of the necessity for the military is, especially in possibly the biggest United States military-based town in the world. How they control every aspect of life around there, including if folks can sleep, because they are constantly low-flying jets over your house.
Okay, well, another thing is there are chem tankers here. The Omega Supertanker I have captured several times on film, and it's on my YouTube channel. Now, I'm going to stop saying that it's on my YouTube channel because almost everything that I'm talking about you can find on my YouTube channel. But anyways, so we actually captured them on film, refueling several times. Now, the Omega Supertanker is a known chem tanker. Today, I actually witnessed another chem tanker taking off from the airport. Now, the military airport is just for the jets, the jet
training. Hey, can you tell us what airport that was taking off from?
Oceana Military Base.
Thank you. Yes.
They all, right. They all take off from Oceana Military Base. There's always these, you know, weird, unidentified, unmarked white or silver tankers that go there to refuel, and then they will just fly off. And, of course, we see the damage that they did today. I posted all the videos. Not all of them. I just posted a few of them. And actually, I want to state something else. So, Facebook, I posted three videos, and I went to post the fourth one, and I tagged some people in it, and Facebook said, you are blocked from posting. We believe you are misusing this, or you're using this the wrong way, or something like that. And I'm like, you bastards. You know I'm not using anything the wrong way. I'm tagging my own friends in a video. I've only posted three videos, so they had already cut me off from tagging, so I can no longer tag anybody for probably tonight, or they didn't give me an amount of time. I tried to tag it again, and it said that you're misusing this option and whatever like that. So I was just like, okay, that's fine. I'll just post my videos. But, you know, the censorship that they do to people like us, they've taken down numerous, countless channels of mine. I keep having to, you know, I'm surprised I've kept this Facebook page as long as I have. Usually it gets hacked by the hackers or taken over or just removed. And they'll, on trumped up charges, kind of like you, Chris, they'll say, you know, copyright infringement is a big one. You'll post a picture. Although when you report someone else's page for stealing your pictures, impersonating you, infiltrating you, they do absolutely nothing about it. I didn't mean to get off track, but yeah, back to the military. So the military here is completely complicit. I call them on a daily basis. They actually cut me off from calling this one number because they said I have to call the noise pollution hotline. Now, the noise pollution hotline actually states on the message that they will not be contacting anybody back, and your report will not hinder or change their operations in any way. Okay, so it's basically just a blank line for aware and awake people to call and complain about the noise. Okay, it's not the noise that we care about, although the noise itself is asinine. They actually crashed down one of my paintings. You know that big painting that's on my wall? I'm sure you guys have seen it. I posted pictures mm-hmm. of my house. Mm-hmm. It's the one that my friend painted. It actually came crashing down because of the low-flying helicopters that train over my house. We actually had a jet crash into an apartment complex a few, right up the street from my house, crashed into the apartment complex. They said no one died. They said no one was there, although there were cars all in the, there were cars all in the parking lot. It was another cover-up. They more than likely killed many people in that, and they just covered it up like they'd do anything.
Oh, that was serious. Shocking.
Yeah, that was insane. And the fumes from that alone, you know, plagued the entire area. You couldn't be anywhere near there because of the fumes. They were just, like, toxic, of course. But they covered that up, and everybody was so happy because the pilot survived, and they said nobody got killed. Do you really think in an apartment complex that they plowed into, nobody got killed? Give me a break, dude. One of my friends said that they saw footage of somebody on fire that was, like, swarming all around and, like, freaking out, and then they never were able to find that again. It was just covered up. I believe people were killed in it. That's just my personal opinion, you know?
That was a number of years ago, and I remember thinking the same thing. That it was shocking for a jet fighter to crash into an apartment complex in the middle of the day and have no casualties and no injuries either. It just doesn't make any sense. Well, we're coming into the last part of the first hour of the Militia Intelligence Report. And with me, the special guest with me has been Amanda Bays, a.k.a. Madison Star Moon. We'll put a link in the comment section on Renegade Broadcasting for her page and her testimony before the congressional EPA. Hearing on the EPA and chemtrails. And we're gonna give Amanda probably the last 2 minutes, probably 2.5 minutes till the bottom of the hour break. And Amanda, you're more than welcome to stay on the whole call because we're going to cover more weather warfare type topics, and we're also going to open it up to the false flag report, Hurricane Matthew, UN elections control, the DHS election hacking scandal that's kind of blowing up today. And you're more than welcome to stay, and I welcome all of your opinions. But if you need to go, you can go, and I'll just give you probably about the last 2 minutes to say whatever it is you'd like to close this out. And,
sure.
And I thank you very much for coming on the show tonight.
It's been an honor to be on your show. And I just want to know, is there an archive for this, or will there be?
Yeah, we usually have the archives up maybe like 15, 20 minutes. I don't want to jinx it, but yeah, it's usually up pretty shortly after the show.
Wow, that's awesome. Okay,
yeah,
I have
yeah,
a formal,
surprising.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Confidence.
I have a formal statement I'd like to make, and so it's not going to take me 2 minutes, but I'd like to read it.
Yeah, go for
okay,
it.
Okay, so I have called, recorded, and reported chemtrails to the EPA, FAA, DEQ, Department of Transportation, FBI, local police, state police, the White House, mainstream media news, the Inspector General, Department of Defense, military, meteorologists, AccuWeather, my congressman, Department of Justice, NASA, NOAA, FEMA, the FCC, Department of Energy, the Sheriff's Office, atmospheric scientists, the Health Department, Evergreen and Brookhaven National Laboratory. To date, no one has addressed any of my concerns. All of these people are guilty of omission, failure to act. A conspiracy of this magnitude is overwhelming to grasp. How can it be that everyone is so compromised? You would think that somewhere along the way, I would have found at least one honest person that cared enough about the planet and humanity to refuse to cover up this insidious agenda. Instead, I have only been met with excruciating apathy and criminal negligence. My heart bleeds for this planet. Without the help we so desperately need, our world will continue to crumble right before our eyes. I wish I had the answers to what we should do. I am left with unanswered questions and a soul that cries out while no one listens. I wrote this, I posted this a while back, but it still stands true today. I want to encourage everyone to fight against the chemtrails, geoengineering, airplane pollution, weather warfare, whatever you want to call it. It is happening. It is a global epidemic. And I want to thank you again for having me on your show. Thank you again, guys.
We'll be back at the top of the hour. Again, thanks to Amanda Bays, a.k.a. Madison Star. Hey, welcome back, everyone. This is the second hour of the Militia Intelligence Report. I'm a man called Chris Dorsey, and you're listening to the Renegade Broadcast Network, renegadebroadcast.com. And on the line with me, I've got a couple callers. I've got Glenn Sutphin with me, and also a caller from the 504. We'll get to in just a minute. We just want to. I just want to take this moment to again thank Amanda, aka Madison Star Moon, for joining us. It was very important information, because not only do we document this stuff, but we also document the cover up of these crimes. Not only are we documenting the election fraud and the weather warfare and the psychological operations you know, the media manipulation, we're documenting them, we're verifying them, and we're presenting it to the folks who are alleged to enforce the law. But what they are is engaged in warfare against us. So we know and document that the government is engaged in all sorts of war against us. And a couple of topics I want to throw out there, because I'm going to open the lines up. The number to contact us is 747-222-8807. That number again, 747-222-8807. You can cover anything that we had in the first hour as far as the weather warfare, anything with regarding our guest. And also, I want to throw a couple things out there. On Saturday night, Alec Baldwin played Donald Trump in a infamous now Saturday Night Live skit for its, I think it's either the 42nd or 43rd season premiere of Saturday Night Live, which I of course grew up watching from the time I was probably, I don't know. I mean, I remember that stuff when I was 5 years old, but you know, I watched it intently from the age of eight, and I still maybe we'll watch a little bit every now and again. But it's interesting Alec Baldwin played Donald Trump, because Alec Baldwin and Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton and Ehud Barak and a number of the who's who of the global elite are involved in the Jeffrey Epstein pedophile scandal. So it's interesting that Alec Baldwin, who is now famous for playing Donald Trump, also is involved in the same child rape ring forwarded by their buddy Jeffrey Epstein. Glenn called in and discussed a little bit about Hurricane Matthew and how that's gonna affect a number of things in a number of different places in the tropics. And it seems like it's gonna cause some sort of issue to us here in the East Coast of the United States. Also, I really would like to cover a lot of this Syria issue and the fact that the largest military killing machines on the planet are combining forces to decimate everything about life in Syria. And then what I'm talking about is the Russia and US and Israel and Saudi Arabia and Great Britain and Turkey and France and others all joining forces to just annihilate a small country as part of a larger plan that's been, you know, in the planning stages for decades to just annihilate this country, Syria, cause a refugee crisis, create a, you know, war crimes that would have every government leader of the world convicted, because they're all complicit in this activity. And it makes me sick when I see that the two largest militaries, Russia and the U.S., which are just part of the same larger operation, they're acting as if they're rivalries, and that rivalry is causing, or that proxy war, which is all concocted by the Jew bankers directing this entire operation, that that something different's going on, that Russia and the United States are not working together to destroy that country, but somehow they have differing opposing views on how to save it. But that's just nothing but BS, because we know that when the U.S. hit the latest target and killed civilians, we know that the U.S. and the Australian bombing mission conferred with Russia before it happened. Also, Glenn mentioned to me earlier on the phone about UN elections officials who are going to be taking over the United States elections. We'll get into that. Of course, the news today is the DHS is now investigating, but what they're really doing is they're covering up that elections for all of the state, the election boards for all the states are being hacked into, and the voter rolls of at least 20 states, according to media reports today, have been hacked into. And I just want to say all elections are fixed. They're rigged 100%. They're setting up a scenario by which, just like in 2000, we know that the election in 2000 was rigged. It doesn't take a genius to figure that out. But they're setting up for the reaction after the rigging of the elections, more so than the past two and even three elections. There's going to be a big hubbub after the elections because nobody's going to be able to trust the results. And this is starting to sink into the American people that these elections are 100% rigged. And if you participate in it, you're part of the problem. So I'm going to invite in 504. I think that might be Jeff from Alabama, and he might just be listening. So we'll check in with 504 real quick. 504, are you there?
No, Chris, that's David from Louisiana.
David. Okay. David.
I couldn't connect.
Okay,
I had to bring in another phone.
Okay, right on. Thanks. We're going to go to Glenn. I want to get your comments on the subjects we just mentioned there.
The election fraud, or the selection fraud, I should say. It's not really an election. It's a selection. We know that. And like I told you, you know, they're bringing in the UN, like 500 overseers to oversee the election now. It's like twice, three times as many as they've ever had in an election. And, you know, and then Russia's the one that's hacking it. Russia's the one that's hacking it. No, they're not. We're doing it ourselves. The government, the NSA, they're doing it themselves. They've already said that the Diebold machines are all rigged. I mean, and they found ballots of, you know, Hillary's ballots, all these ballots that are already filled out, you know, and here in Harrisonburg, dead people are voting, you know, often and early. And so, you know, you got dead people, you got cats and dogs on the registry, you got all this stuff going on. And then they're going to bring in the UN to make sure that it's okay. No, the UN is taking over. We're walking in, you know, they've already stated that what's after America? North American Union. We're already in the North American Union. We're run by the UN. I mean, it's coming in. They're bringing it in. Getting back to the topic from last hour, I'd like to say about the genocide and everything, all that wraps up into Agenda 21 for the whole planet.
Yeah, thanks, Glenn. Yeah, absolutely.
You know, just to congeal that, it's all Agenda 21. The chemtrails, the geoengineering, it's all listed in Agenda 21. I'll just get back to the hole in the ozone over Australia and the Antarctic and stuff, that they had to fly planes and spray chemicals to close the thing up. That was chemtrailing also. And it doesn't happen. It doesn't exist. They said it on the news that they were doing it, and then it magically healed up. So, I mean, if you're going with it, anything that comes out of the ass end of an airplane is a chemical trail. So it's a chem trail. Get over it. Yes, there are thousands of programs that they're using, different things to do. It's all part of this magical gem they call Agenda 21, which is morphing into 2030. And that's another topic for another day, but I just like to put that out there. But getting back to the election fraud, we know it's going on. Yeah, I don't think that 2020 there's going to be an election the way it's going. I mean, we've already proven the thing is a crock of crap, you know. So
yeah,
I just want to put that out there.
Yeah, the elections are 100% rigged, and they make a joke out of it. We kind of referenced that with Alec Baldwin playing Donald Trump.
Well, they're laughing right in our face about it.
Yeah,
I mean,
absolutely.
Let's get real. They're putting, like, after the mass occurred, if they get up there and they start dancing and play music and laugh and we pulled it over on you, you stupid idiot.
You're talking about the Orlando shooting and the
Well, not only the Orlando, but they've done it to several other ones. You know, that, I mean, all these psyops and these rex drills that they run, and they, oh, these are real, and then no, they're not real. They're just staged. The media says they're real. Everybody thinks that they're real.
Right, but specifically, when I hear you talking about the singing and dancing, I specifically think about the lawyers, the judges, the hospital workers, mm-hmm. the police, the fire, and the ambulance in Orlando, Florida, doing this ridiculous dance routine following the staged Orlando, and I'll quote Russell Pappalardo, Holocaust in Orlando, which was the stage shooting at the Pulse nightclub, which didn't happen, by G4S Security Services, Omar Mateen, who is a known television actor. Look up Omar Mateen, and what is it? The IMBD? Is that what you would look him up under, Glenn?
Yeah, or GS or G4S.
G4S, yeah. But I'm talking about the fact that he was an actor, and isn't there something called the IMBD that...
there's the database. Yeah,
the database.
Brain isn't working too well with this migraine.
You're covering a lot of subjects, and I appreciate
But okay, getting to the Orlando thing real quick. It was pre-planned. They already came out and they said that you can not get any more information. They security locked it. And then it came out that it was a pre-planned event. That is a rex drill. That is a psyop. That is a false flag. Whatever word you want to put in there works. That's what it is. It didn't happen. And they're trying to tell us these things happen. You have to listen to the media. The media doesn't know what the media says.
Okay, Glenn.
You know,
So they're pre-planned events. We know that. And that they're like with the shooting in Townsville, South Carolina, they had a drill going on that day, mm-hmm. and they've had numerous live shooter drills, just like the scenario that played out there last week. And also, in the other staged event, you said you can call it a false flag, or you can call it a staged event, whatever you want to call it, pre-planned, or a drill gone live, that the same thing happened in the Hoboken, New Jersey train wreck, because that was a drill carried out by the New York, New Jersey Port Authority. Mm-hmm. And they were operating a emergency drill very close to Hoboken, New Jersey at Cape Liberty. So, yes, we know that they're just running these drills over and over again, and we know that they're running these psychological operations, and we know that there's going to be no solution through these rigged elections. There's going to be no solution through the folks, you know, the criminals investigating themselves and punishing themselves, because as soon as you turn them in, they get raises. They're not doing something wrong. They're doing something right in the eyes of their criminal bosses. And of course, this is a part of the Zionist occupied government. This is a New World Order, Jewish agenda. But also, this is a larger Luciferian agenda. You know, Nick covered the connections between Scientology, the Mormon religion, the CIA, and the secret government. And also the fact that above all of these seems to be the Jewish hidden hand. And David, David, can we get your thoughts? And did you have anything else that's going on that you see with this going on in the news, either that we need to cover that happened last week or some things coming up this week that we haven't mentioned so far?
Well, what was I thinking of a minute ago? Oh, that's right. About 2 days ago, they handed over control of most of the servers of the internet to the United Nations.
I forgot to mention that.
Yeah. So, okay, Glenn, do you know anything about that?
Yeah, that's Obama basically handed over U.S. property to the U.N. and said, this is going to be, and the internet went to the U.N. So, again, Agenda 21, playing into the new world order. It's all the agenda. The agenda is going forward. It doesn't matter what's going on. The elect, this elect, take the Logan piece. And Obama said he's handing sovereignty of the United States over to the UN,
okay,
which is what,
okay. Well, hey,
you know.
Let's go get into that real quick. And we know, hey, I just thought of some more things to cover, and it's all going to dovetail in together. And
thank David for that. Thank you, David.
Yeah, thanks, David. Because of course, mm-hmm. we all know that the internet, the so-called World Wide Web. You know, it uses the lines of the old British-controlled telegraph system, which became the telephone system, and that the internet is more accurately should be called DARPANET because it's a
it was ARPANET.
It was
ARPA
DARPANET,
and IARPA.
It still is.
Yeah,
and it still is. So and that we know that because of what we see that's happening in front of our own eyes and declassified documents that we covered on last week's program, that the United States military takes its marching orders not from the United States Congress, which is mandated in Article 1, Section 8 and Article 1, Section 9 and, you know, Article 1, Section 10 of Constitution for United States. However, what the regulating bodies of the United States military are is NATO and the United Nations. So when the United States military has control of something, it is this international body, which is the governing body that's tied very closely to the Bank for International Settlements and the World Bank and the IMF, and that's called the United Nations. That's the political governing arm of this banking cartel, which creates money for all the governments of the world. And that's the Bank for International Settlements, which is located in Basel, Switzerland. So we have that to consider. And of course, thanks to David and Glenn for bringing that up, because that's very, very important, because the airwaves are public. And of course, we're operating under Wi-Fi right now. So nothing could be more public than the internet, which you all at home are hearing us. This is through Wi-Fi. It's the public airways, which is owned by the public. And we need to start requiring that they hand this valuable property back over to the people. We require the valuable property of our court system. We require our valuable property of the jails to put all the government leaders into while they await trial and conviction for either misprison of treason or actual treason itself. Misprison, those guys are all gone to jail for 5 years at least. And if you're found guilty of treason, which every high-ranking government official of every government agency is guilty of treason. And as I'm going to, you know, piggyback on what I heard Kyle Hunt, the founder of Renegade Broadcasting, say in another episode in another show, and I'm going to paraphrase it because I don't want to say I'm quoting him exactly, but we need to be a part of the torch and pitchfork party. We need to be a part of this gathering of minds that says my God, these folks intend to wipe us out, and we've got to do something about this right now. That's why the Virginia militia exists. That's why it is written into the law, into state law and into federal law. Look at all the militia clauses. Do a Google search for militia clauses. And just about every state in our common law United States, as set forward and mandated by the Constitution, has the militia as the top law enforcement agency of any other. And usually it's the only one mentioned. So that's important to consider. It's also important to consider that according to Leon Panetta, while he was testifying before the Senate, he stated very clearly that the United States military may, if it feels like it, inform Congress of what their actions are going to be, but that they take orders from NATO and the United Nations. Now, that is a clear violation of the Constitution. That's one of those statements where if you just hear that and you ignore everything else that we've said, which we don't ask you to do, we ask you to consider everything we've said. But even if you threw everything else out, just that one statement by Leon Panetta makes the entire infrastructure of the United States government treasonous. So I pass that back to you, Glenn. What do you feel about that statement that I just made about the control of our military in foreign hands is the abomination against the basis of our government?
Well, it is first, I'm getting feedback.
You're coming through loud and clear on my end, Glenn.
Okay. First thing is, it's not our government. I don't like people. Not my government.
Good point.
Not my government. I didn't ordain the thing. I did not give them consent. I do not vote. I do not care about government. It is not my government. It's not our government. The government that is in place is a treasonous organization that was put there by the dark cabal, period, point blank. They're operating not under the Constitution. They're blatantly saying we're not following the Constitution because the United States has been dissolved. The North American Union has a whole new Constitution. So yeah, They're following new orders, following the UN, following the One World Order. They are doing what they say, but in as representing us as our government, they are very treasonous in what they are saying and doing.
Absolutely. Great point.
They have hostily taken over what was our government and put this new thing in that looks like our government, but it's not our government. It's a totally different organism in there. That it was a parasite that grew and became what Eisenhower said, you know, he warned about it, the military industrial complex.
He said these people were coming in. Let me cut in there because Eisenhower is one of the biggest criminals in the history of humanity.
I fully understand.
Right. And
I'm saying what he had said.
Right. Because he was using his lesser magic because they have to inform us.
Right.
What they're
he was
going
telling
to do.
Us this is what's
hey,
coming.
Glenn, let me real quick. You know, lead you into something that I know you've talked about a lot, and then I want to get to David, and we're coming into the half hour break too. So just consider that when you say that we're operating under something completely different than the Constitution and the government of the 50 states, what exactly are we operating? Are we operating under, say, FEMA regions? Is that what the current illegitimate government structure is operating under instead of a constitutional 50-state republic?
Technically, yes, we're under FEMA regions now, but then we're going into mega regions. So the FEMA regions are going to break up into different regions. There's still going to be 10 of them, but they're mega regions with these mega cities, and the best thing to describe it is Hunger Games. You have your districts, regions, and you've got tribes, and they're breaking us up into tribes.
But to be clear, we're operating not under the government of, say, you know, I mean, there's aspects and elements. I mean, certainly the general assemblies in different states and the Congress meet, but we're operating under the continuity of government and FEMA regions as set forward in many declassified Department of Homeland Security and FEMA documents, what's called the continuity of operations or continuity of government.
Correct.
And then our real government is operating in bases like Raven Rock Complex or Pentagon Reservation, Site C in Washington County, Mount Weather and Mount Pony, and in underground bases throughout Virginia, throughout Maryland, in southern Pennsylvania, Colorado, etc. And David, I want to get you back in, and probably we'll have like a minute, and then we'll get you in after the next break. I wanted to discuss the fact that there are FEMA regions running us, and then when there is a disaster like Katrina, FEMA comes in, and instead of alleviating problems, they make it worse. And I want to reference these so-called FEMA trailers, which contained toxic formaldehyde, and that the majority of individuals who have lived in these trailers that they had to wait for are now sick or dying or dead. David.
Chris, thank you for bringing that up, because I had a grandmother that she had a faulty heater in one of her FEMA trailers. And my dad went to go check on her one night, and he's lucky he caught her in time, because she had obtained carbon monoxide poisoning, and it could have killed her if she would have been exposed to it any longer. But she was lucky to have come out of it alive. There was even a local news story and all about it. I think she was her case was one of the first cases that started the awareness of the dangers of these faulty heaters inside these FEMA trailers. And folks still have FEMA trailers everywhere. I mean, it's
on the Eastern Standard Time here in Richmond, Virginia. You're listening to the Militia Intelligence Report on Renegade Broadcasting. And before the break, David was discussing the deadly FEMA trailers and his personal experience how his grandmother was almost a victim of that, or was a victim of that and survived, we should say. And we're going to let David finish up his thoughts on that. And then we've got also another caller from 205 area code calling in. And we're going to check in on that caller as well. So go ahead, David.
I'm just going to give a brief comment and then let you get to the other caller. All I have to say is the seasons have changed, not just in the weather, like what we're talking about, but the seasons within us. As Kyle says, our time is right more than ever before, because we have a means now to really give everybody the other side of things where they have never thought possible before. Usually most of my podcasts I do with Russell, I always try to quote him somewhere between to provoke the audience and into a new way of thinking. Well, people have to realize that this is a very real danger we're up against. Thanks to you, Chris, because you really demonstrated to me with the confrontations that you have with these officials about how real, not only ignorant, but dangerous they can be to you. And that it takes star moon to really help get the ball rolling for the rest of us to be inspired and hopefully take up something very similar to that, because we need more people to engage in the kind of things to where they're actually confronting it head on instead of just making everybody aware of it, because once you get enough people aware, that's when the time is right.
Okay. And, yeah, I do want to thank you very much. Thank you very much for that. Now I want to follow up and say,
no problem, Chris.
Say, David, we have a virtual and a visual and video handbook on how to deal with your servants in government, because any government official, the only thing one must know about them, if they are a lawful man or woman, if they are of the body of the people, is that any government official is your servant, and they must at all times be amenable to you. So if you're operating with any government agent in any other manner, and you're not filming them, recording them, confronting them on their crimes, then you're not discussing and you're not requiring things of them, because the only thing you can do to a government agent properly and lawfully is give them requirements, because man and woman, people always have standing over government, because government is our two-dimensional creation, just like the same with money. Money is our two-dimensional creation, and it is now been usurped and what's the word I'm looking for? I would say bastardized by the criminal Jews who now control it. And I want to go to caller in 205 area code. Caller, are you there? Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Birmingham.
Okay.
I've just tuned into your show. Would you elaborate more on your idea of the government being a two-dimensional creation and that we are always superior to it?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's basically kind of a one way that I like to begin conversations with any government agent, because obviously we know that. I mean, I'll speak for an example, you know, and I would say folks like Descartes and others, they speak on this subject much more eloquently than I do. But basically, God is a creator of man. I know God exists because I have the ability to imagine such a figure that is created. And of course, I didn't create myself. And of course, you know, I didn't create the bees and the birds and the trees, even though, you know, human beings have the capability of reproducing. We cannot create everything else that surrounds us on this earth. And that government is always formed by man, and I'm using the generic man, like the biblical man, that, you know, male and female are man, the mankind as a whole. So I could say man and woman. I could say the body of the people. They always form a government, and always a government is formed, a legitimate government is formed to protect. I should say, the property of man or the people, which the property of the people is anything that the people have gained through their own labor. So therefore, the government, the way it functions now, using those precepts that we know to be clear facts, has no legitimate standing to behave in the manner in which it is. Which it is as if the government is our God, and we must ask permission of the government before we do anything. And the government has rights more than God to annihilate us and take us out for absolutely no reason, with no recourse. So we know that that is the inversion of the intent, and we know that that is acting against the best interest of the people and all living things. And so we must take any means necessary to abolish this corrupt system, which is carrying out these crimes against us and carrying out war and genocide against us. So anything more specific than that?
No, sir. I like to hear that subject expounded upon by different people.
Yeah,
I'm in wholehearted agreement with you. But it seems very self-evident to me. But unfortunately, it seems to be like those people that think, as you and I do, about the role of government to the citizenry and vice versa, are in the minority. That most people are actually statist. They would just rather their state go their way, you know?
Absolutely. So. And I think the main reason for that is because we see earlier and earlier in the lives of Americans where the parents turn over their children to the state. And that's basically what happens from birth. A lot of folks have covered this, how, you know, the sexual trauma for almost all boys in America and many baby girls is the sexual trauma inducing circumcision ritual, which, you know, we don't have a moil and we don't have these, you know, creepy rabbis, you know, doing that. But certainly our body is mutilated, you know, pretty much from the beginning. And who's doing that? The state is indoctrinating us. And then we have, of course, pre-kindergarten, which was pushed more than anyone, I would say, in the political sphere than Tim Kaine while he was governor of Virginia. And he, of course, is the Democratic vice presidential nominee who was, of course, a Jesuit assassin and involved in all sorts of nefarious activity on behalf of the Vatican involving child prostitution rings while he was before and during and after he was governor of Virginia and mayor of Richmond. So yeah, absolutely. I don't think there's any other way to look at it. The only other way to look at it is you either have our attitude as far as the purpose of government or one is a slave. It's pretty much that cut and dry to me. Either you're a man or a woman or you're a slave. If you comply with this government tyranny and you go along with your own annihilation, you're a slave and you're a masochist. And I, you know, I don't want those folks on my team. They're too stupid. Or they're too
You just now used the term slave. And of course, the definition of a slave, if you were my slave, that would mean that I would be entitled to 100% of the product of your labor, or I would claim it for my own. That's how you make a slave. But to get back to the government and to speak of overreaching government, at what percentage is it not considered slavery? You know what I mean? I take 100% of the product of your labor, you are my slave. But at what percentage is the cutoff line? 50%, 25%? Well, I mean, what exactly?
Okay.
You know, how much of a slave are we?
That's a good point. And I want to get into that real quick. And I want to give an example. But I also want to move on to a couple other things. We got about 15 minutes to go in the show. It's been a great show so far. But I'll bring up that example. So during the slave times, and we all know that you know, African Americans owned slaves in the United States, and that, of course, you know, just like today, the Jews run the international slave trade. They run the, you know, slave trade today. Israel is which is nothing more than a Rothschild fiefdom, and we want to get into some of the evils of the Rothschilds because I have been remiss and I haven't covered my least favorite family and the first that's going to be in front of the firing squad, the Rothschilds. So I want to get into a little bit of that, but I do want to point out what you were saying about slavery, and it's, you know, it's a claim of 100% of one's labor. But I want to point out something about modern day slavery that's almost more insidious in some ways than the slavery that we're taught in our public fool system to think is the only slavery that ever existed, and that's the colonial American slave system, which was run by the Monsantos and the Jews out of Rhode Island, and the Dutch masters were, of course, of Ashkenazi and Sephardim bloodlines. So
Charleston, South Carolina had a large.
Thank you very much. You're right, Charleston. Yeah. Everywhere there were reports, but of course, Charleston, a lot of degenerate Jew slave traders down there, of course. And you know, I'm a I'm a Confederate. My family were Confederates, and I prefer the Articles of Confederation over the Constitution, but I'm also a constitutionalist. So I'll make that very clear, because it's all the common law, and that's the law of my ancestors. And, you know, over the years, I realized that we can't do anything else except for live the life that's set forward, you know, by our ancestors, because that's the blood that's within us. So today, say, like the homeless folks, when we were, you know, infiltrating that government-controlled Occupy Richmond movement, we saw the homeless population, and they were working. Many of them were working jobs, and they didn't have a home. Now, interesting, they called slavery, where 100% of the payment is claimed, or 100% of the work of the slave is claimed by the owner of the slave. But that's not simply how it went. They had to provide shelter. They had to provide homes. They had to provide a roof. The government does not do that right now, because there are more empty houses. There are about 10 times to 100 times more empty houses in the city of Richmond than there are homeless folks. So if they opened up all the houses that are sitting empty, that are just sitting nowhere, even homes that are ready to be lived in, the homeless population of the United States is dwarfed by the number of uninhabited homes. So that's pure slavery right there, where they don't even allow a human being to have a home. Now, I say all human beings, all animals must have homes. All human beings, all animals, regardless of anything, should not be subjected to torture and should not be subjected to anything that is against their will. It's very simple. That's how government should function, in my opinion. And that's how the law states it should function. And that's our sacred common law. So, yeah, great comments. And I really do appreciate it. And I want to get into the fact that, and I heard this on from a couple sources. And I'll say Sinead, of course, the great and illustrious Sinead, exposed, among other folks, the Jewish blood within Donald Trump. And of course, it's coming out. And Robert Revolt, on his program last night on RBN, Incendiary Radio with Robert Revolt, stated that Alex Jones was referencing the fact that Hillary Clinton was covering up the fact that her father was Jewish. Now, this is being discussed on the mainstream media, and I can certainly see it from her appearance. And, of course, Chelsea, therefore, is, you know, married to a Jew, just like Donald Trump's children, and so on. So we know these things to be a fact. So we know that not only are there Jews directing these puppets, Donald Trump, reality TV show actor and professional wrestler, etc. And Hillary Clinton, I see her on Saturday Night Live. She's just a trained actor, but that they have Jewish blood within them, and that they're not there. It's beyond that, just that they're slaves and they're being directed around by Jewish billionaires and trillionaires. And this segues nicely into Friday's funeral for one of the ultimate criminals of organized Jewry of all time, and that's Shimon Peres, 9/11 co-conspirator, one of the fathers of the Israeli nuclear program, and Jewish terrorist and Jewish gangster, Shimon Peres. And the fact that every world leader put on those beanies that I like to call Hanukkah helmets, they call them kippahs or yarmulkes or whatever they wish, but they all put on those ridiculous circumcised penis condoms on their heads, and they show their fealty to the Rothschild fiefdom of Israel with Israeli flags flying in the background while paying homage to, I would say, one of the criminal masterminds behind this current war against the American people that we are now experiencing. And I just wanted to point out that Israel is nothing but a Rothschild fiefdom. It is an extension of the Jewish banking infrastructure, and it is a perfect epitome of the combination and the coming together of the international banking industry and the international military industrial complex. And I want to get Glenn's thoughts on those topics. And I also want to talk to David and see if Jeb has anything to say down there in Alabama. So I'll start with Glenn, and I think we're going to use this last part to close out the show. So maybe if you could give me your thoughts about 2 minutes each. Go ahead, Glenn.
Well, I pretty much stated, you know, what I wanted to say on the show tonight about the government and everything. We all know it's illegitimate. We all know, you know, at the top of it is Rothschild Zionist Jew. So, you know, what can you say? It's self-evident. The more it's self-evident, the more, you know, there ain't much to say about it. On that, I'll just close out tonight. And you have a good night. It was a good show, Chris. And thanks, thank you, Glenn, for having me on, man.
Oh, anytime. Hey, thanks for coming on. And, you know, I really do appreciate all your insight. And God bless. And if you want to stay on the line and if you come up with anything more, then feel free. But I'm going to go then to Alabama first, and then we'll go to New Orleans to close it out. And then I'll close out the show after that. Go ahead.
Well, just speaking about Israel, they are actually in a very precarious situation right now. And I think maybe these international Jews may be turning their back or stabbing these nationalist Zionist Jews that just, you know, love Israel so much. And I think they're going to break Israel, to be quite honest with you.
Hey, that's great point.
Yes, and that's I'd just like to leave you with that and let people think on that for a little bit.
Okay, before we go to David, real quick, you know, this seems part of like how Vladimir Putin, the Jew, FSB, KGB agent, bloodline Bolshevik whose family goes back to the inner circle of Stalin, and that this is part of the Eurasian Kalergi plan that Nick and Kyle and many of the others on this network discuss. And that's a great point brought up. And thanks again. And we're going to move on to David in Louisiana. Go ahead, David. David, are you there? Okay. Seem to have lost.
Chris.
Yeah, go ahead, David.
Sorry, I had to move by a window.
Okay,
a lot of cloud
go for
cover.
It, David.
You know, what Jeb from Alabama touched on was what I was going to say, because I'm really starting to see how they don't mind throwing Israel under the bus. You know, you have BDS movement, which is mostly left-wing. Then you have the True Torah Jews, Jews Against Zionism, and it seems like all these other COINTELPRO groups is what I'm really leaning towards lately, because they don't mind. As I've said before, they don't mind throwing Israel under the bus. They really need a patsy. They really need a real Judas goat.
Sure, David. Hey,
that's what Israel
is. I'll let you go on real quick, but isn't that sacrificing some of their own bloodline? Isn't that a part of their protocols?
It sure is. I can't tell you which specific
but
number,
it's in the protocols of the Learned Elders of Zion that's a
correct.
Great strategy. It's to throw folks off, you know, where they say things like, "Hey, look, you know, Israel's in trouble," but you don't see that behind all of these anti-Israel movements, you find a Jew directing it. And that's one thing that I found really absurd about all this anti-Zionist. Not that there aren't, you know, a handful of Jews that are legitimately opposing, you know, the abomination that organized Jewry has unleashed on the world, but that they are the exclusive controllers of all anti-Israeli and anti-organized Jewish movements, besides the legitimate ones like this one. You know, you're talking, you referenced the COINTEL operations, but, you know, a lot of the so-called whistleblowers, they're not really so much whistleblowers as just controlled opposition to make sure we don't go, oh, okay, yeah, once we get done with Israel, okay, problem solved. Good point, because we need to, it needs to be the goal, the legitimate goal of the body of the people is to regain our property. And the United States of America is our property. You know, Europe is our property because it's in our blood. And you know, that's our property. And our property also is the property of any individual who wishes to impose their will against us. Because any individual or group or government agency that intends to impose their will against us, we will abolish and annihilate with prejudice. So go ahead, David. Let you get another minute to close out, and then we're going to close out the program.
We have the most moral and the absolute most lawful standing in the position we're in right now. That's what I'm stating to the body of the people. I'm stating this to anybody who wears a badge, goes by any title in an alphabetical agency, whether you're a lieutenant or Captain Crunch, as Chris put it. You're clowns in costumes. Some of you remind me of the man on the side of a cereal box, and others just remind me of a bad bully in high school. But when confronted head on, you cower in the shadows, only to attack like the thieves in the night that you are. Renegade is building awareness against you and will bring attention to everybody so that we may move forward and enforce the law and actually serve and protect the public like they should be doing. But it's up to us to take up that job.
Yeah, it's up to us. Great point, David. It is up to us, because if we don't do it, it will not be done. Nobody else has shown the fortitude, the ability, the intelligence, or the courage to do so. We are not the best because, it's impossible to be the best, but we are the only ones that are doing that. And when I say we, I'm talking about the militia. I'm talking about Renegade Broadcasting. I'm talking about the True Resistance. I'm talking about the only official body of the people. No one else can call themselves the body of the people unless we say so, because they're not acting within the law. Only we are. And I'd like to take this opportunity as we close out the program. This is not just a prosecution. This is also our opportunity to talk directly to our enemies and say to every government official, do everything you can to have your bosses arrested, convicted, and executed. That's the only thing that will save you. That's the only thing that will keep you and your family safe, because otherwise we are going to convict you and execute you all. This is Chris Dorsey, the Virginia Militia, saying peace and God bless.
Thank you, Chris.